Hello everyone, welcome back to another tutorial video. Today I'm going to be showing you how to use the game bar in Windows 10 to record your desktop or record gameplay footage directly from the Windows game bar. So as you can see, I have a game open in the background, and this only works if you have a game open. You can't just record like Photoshop or Premiere Pro or something like that. A game needs to be open, and it needs to detect that you have a game running and open. So before we dive into this, you need to make sure that your settings are correct in order to have everything work the way that it should. So go ahead and go to your Windows taskbar here and go into settings. Once you're here under settings, what you're going to want to do is find the gaming settings right here. It shows a little Xbox logo. Go to the gaming settings here. And then once here under the gaming settings, go to captures. It's the second or third one down there. And make sure that you have this enabled. Make sure that you have record audio when I record a game. Record in the background while I'm playing a game. This will have it to where it automatically records. I wouldn't really do that, to be honest with you. And then down below, this is just going to make sure that you have all of your audio and video settings properly set up. So you want your microphone volume, you can adjust it here. You can adjust your system volume, which in this case will be the game volume. And then you can choose whether you want to record in 30 or 60 FPS. And then video quality, you can change from standard to high if that's something that you want to do. And then if you want your mouse cursor to show up in the gameplay recording, you can either check or uncheck this depending on what you want your settings to be there. Now, as far as screenshots and game clips, they will be saved to a specific folder on your PC. The top setting here under capture says save screenshots and clips to right here, Dusty Videos Capture. You can open this folder and you can even change this and find a folder. Say I want to save this to my desktop. I can select desktop and then just basically just choose desktop, choose a folder like this one here, and then it automatically changes that folder if you want to. All right. Next, you need to make sure that under game mode here that it is enabled on your PC, because obviously if game mode's not enabled, none of this is going to work. Make sure that it's enabled. Not only that, make sure that your PC supports it, because there are some older ones that do not support the Windows kind of gaming bar feature here. And then go back to the gaming kind of native settings by going to the Xbox game bar here and just make sure that everything is set up the way that you need it to be set up. You can have it set here where you just push the middle button on an Xbox controller and it opens up automatically. So basically, if this here is on, this will enable you to record. But if this is unchecked and it's off, you will not be able to record or do anything that we're going to do in this video. Okay, so make sure your settings are exactly like I just set mine here. Go ahead and close out of your settings window, open up your game, and then go ahead and hold down the Windows key on your keyboard and G. So Windows plus the G key on the keyboard will bring up all of this here, will bring up the Windows bar. So at the very top, we're not going to go over any of this right here. You can kind of set all of that up in settings like we just did. Over on the left-hand side, you're going to see something here that says capture. You can drag these anywhere and everywhere on the screen to make it easier for you to see and navigate the game bar if that's something that you want to do. Under the capture feature here, we have one that says a screenshot. Now, if you hover over these, it will tell you what the hotkey will be. If you want to take a screenshot within a game, you can hover over this option here and see that the Windows key plus Alt plus print screen will then capture a screenshot and send it to the folder that you have set up. Next, we have the record last 30 seconds. This is going to record the last 30 seconds. Did you do something awesome? Did you make an amazing shot in FIFA? Whatever it is, if you want to record the last 30 seconds, open up game bar, click this here, and it will record the last 30 seconds of the game that it is capturing. And if you want to know what game it is capturing, it shows you here. It says like Hearthstone, which is the game that I have open. It'll show you that here. Next, we have our record. So we have our start recording, which is Windows key plus Alt plus R. Again, you can change these hotkeys in the game bar settings that we were just in. The thing that I would check before I started recording any video footage for my gameplay is over here where it says audio. I'm going to drag this to the center of our screen here. We have our audio mix, and then we have our voice. Under mix, this is going to show you where the audio is coming out of. So for me, it's my speakers. And then we will have to, we can even adjust the different applications that are open here. So system sounds, we can reduce the system sounds. We can reduce the sound coming from Hearthstone, which is our current game. And then battle.net is the other app that it's detecting that we could record. I will go ahead and mute that all the way. I don't want anything from there. You can mute and unmute by just clicking the button there as well. And then once you have your sounds the way that you want them, I'd kind of start them around 75 and play with it. Do a couple of test recordings to see how it sounds. You don't want it to blare, kill people's eardrums when you're recording. And then we have our voice tab here. This one is probably the most important. I have so many people who have told me I've tried recording via the Windows Game Bar, but I get no audio from my microphone. It's because you don't have this set up. If you go to the voice tab here, go to the drop-down menu, select your microphone. For me, it's my audio interface, the Scarlett 2i2 here. That's what my Shure SMB microphone is plugged into. You may have a Blue Yeti. You may have a USB microphone. Just make sure it's not like your internal webcam microphone here. Make sure you have your proper microphone selected. And then when you have all of that set up, ready to go, get that out of the way, we can now go ahead and click the record button here. Go to record, and then it will begin recording. Now, how do you know it's recording? Well, right here where it says capture status, I'll drag this over here. You can see that it's beginning to capture right here, and it has a red recording button and dot here, and then it has the duration in which we have already recorded. Now, if I go and hit the Windows plus G key, I will open up the game, and as you can see here, I can go ahead and begin to play the game, and I can go ahead and start recording a couple of things here, and my recording bar is still in the upper right-hand corner. It will not capture the recording bar, so don't worry about that. When you're ready to stop the recording, you can just go up here and click Stop Recording. Once you've done that, the little notification will come up here saying, hey, your game clip has been recorded. Select the Windows key plus G on the keyboard. Go to Show All Captures here. And as you can see, we now have a new capture that is in our gallery. So if we select this one here, we can go to Open File Location. And then as you can see, here is the video clip. Here is the screenshot. Video clips show up with the little film, a little area on the border of the clip there. So if we double click that guy there, it will open that up. And as you can see, it begins to play back that video that we just recorded from the Windows Game Bar. So in closing, make sure you have your settings properly set up within the Game Bar. Make sure you have your microphone audio set up the way that it needs to be. You also know what location that it's going to be saving these files to, and you should be good to go to start recording via the Windows Game Bar. If you have any questions, please put those in the comment section below. Don't forget, if this video helped you out, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel for more great content just like this, and I will see you guys in the next video.